Welcome to the 28th meeting in 2022 of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee. I'd like to remind everyone present to switch their mobile phones to silent. The first item of business is to decide whether to take items 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 in private. Is the committee content to take these items in private?
Yes.
Under agenda item number 2, we're considering two instruments subject to the affirmative procedure. No points have been raised on the draft Public Water Supplies Scotland Amendment Regulations 2022 and the draft Budget to Scotland Act 2022 Amendment Regulations 2023. Is the committee content with these instruments? Yep. Under agenda item number 3, we're considering one instrument subject to the negative procedure. An issue has been raised on this instrument, which is SSI 2022-307. The assured tenancies and private residential tenancies, prescribed notices and forums, miscellaneous temporary modifications, Scotland Regulations 2022. The instrument temporarily modifies the private residential tenancies, prescribed notices and forums, Scotland Regulations 2017, and the rent regulation and assured tenancies forums, Scotland Regulations 2017, by making changes to certain forms and notices that a landlord is required to serve on a tenant when seeking to end a tenancy. The modifications are made in response to emergency measures introduced by the Cost of Living Tenant Protection Scotland Act 2022. In correspondence with the presiding officer, the Scottish Government explained that the 28-day rule cannot be met due to the speed the new legislation is being introduced and amending regulations being required to ensure the forums reflect all eviction grounds on the date the 2022 Act comes into force. The correspondence further states that the coming into force date of the Act and regulations cannot be moved as these measures are urgently needed to help protect tenants during the cost of living crisis. Under Section 28.2 of the Interpretation and Legislative Reform Scotland Act 2010, instruments subject to the negative procedure must be laid at least 28 days before they come into force, not counting recess periods of more than 4 days. This instrument breaches this requirement as it was laid on the 28th of October 2022 and came into force the same day. Does the committee wish to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament on reporting ground J for the failure to comply with the lane requirements? And at the same time, is the committee content with the Scottish Government's explanation provided for the breach of the lane requirements? Oliver?
Thank you, convener. I would just wish to put on record that in this instance, I believe the way in which the legislation that this relates to was rushed through Parliament is clearly a contributing factor to the breach. And whilst respecting the decision of Parliament and understanding the need now for the instrument to come into force, I'm not content for the reason for the breach, as I believe it could have been avoided if this legislation had followed the normal parliamentary procedure.
Okay. Thanks, Oliver. Anyone else wish to comment? Okay. Well, thank you, Oliver. Your comments are noted and are on the record. Is the committee content with the other two recommendations? Yes. Okay, thank you. Under agenda item number 4, we're considering two instruments not subject to any parliamentary procedure. No points have been raised on SSIs 2022-301 and 305. Is the committee content with these instruments? Okay, thank you. And with that, I'll move the committee into private. Thank you.